in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation.
Slipping up, police be tripping up. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap.
That changed the world.
Will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama, with its vicious racists, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
Today I'm going to be talking about what's going on in the world right now because I'm angry. You know, the entire world is angry. How many times can the same thing happen until there's justice? How do they expect us to watch an 8-minute and 46-second video of a man literally begging for his life, and you continue to keep your knee on his neck 2 minutes after he's already dead? Like, and for what? Because you're racist? Because you had no respect for his life? Because you were on a power high? Because you felt safe? You felt safe murdering an innocent man, thinking you're gonna get away with it, with multiple people filming you? You had 3 other cops standing there just watching it happen, and you still continued to keep your knee on his neck like it was nothing, like his life meant nothing. This happens every day. People who are supposed to protect us are killing us for the color of our skin, and they get away with it. Derek Chauvin murdered George Floyd. Thought he was gonna be fine and continue on with his life as he took away someone else's. He thought he was gonna get away with it, like he really did. But I thank God that we all stood together and we're taking a stand. We're fighting for justice right now. And that's just, it's so moving to me that it's not just the black community fighting for these injustices. It's the entire world. Literally the entire world. I'm not just saying like, oh, it's the entire world is fighting for black lives. Like, it's so sad that it took a man, an innocent man, dying for this to happen. But George Floyd is changing the world. And what we need to do is continue to fight all these injustices for everyone else who was wrongfully murdered. We need to continue this. We need to keep the same energy we have right now and not just let it fade away. We need to keep moving. We need to keep protesting. We need to keep signing petitions. We just need to keep it going. So this change we think is happening is actually gonna stick. There is so much change that needs to happen, but when we have a president that is literally giving racist people the power to feel above the law, that change is never gonna happen. When we have a president that is tweeting out that we are thugs for peacefully protesting the death of a man who was murdered for absolutely nothing other than being black, we're called thugs. But when white people are protesting and rioting because their hair salons and nail salons aren't open due to a global pandemic, they're called nice people, and that we should listen to them and hear them out and just ease up and give into it. But when someone is murdered, we're called thugs. We're criminal. We're animals. First off, back in Minneapolis when all this started, Target refused to sell milk, hydrogen peroxide, anything that could help injured protesters, because the cops, they acted out in violence when they were peaceful. They were getting pepper sprayed in the face, beaten for nothing, for peacefully protesting. And what do they get in return? Target refusing to sell them milk to help out with being pepper sprayed. To these protesters just fighting for life, fighting for equality. How does that make sense? Like, no, obviously we should not be burning down buildings and looting and all this. But what do you think's gonna happen? That is the only way our voices are being heard. And we didn't even start half the looting or rioting. People who aren't even part of the movement are looting and rioting and feeding into the fact that black people are criminal and all of this, when in reality, white people are starting half of the looting. And we fight them saying, please stop, please stop. You're hurting our movement. Like, that doesn't make sense. Like, that doesn't make sense. Making them think it's not safe for white people. The world is safe for white people. The color of your skin protects you. If you are not white, you're in danger. And that's just what it is. And you can't be so ignorant and not see that. If you're white and you do not see your privilege, you're being racist without even knowing it. If you're saying you don't see people by color, you should be seeing me by my color. I am proud to be black. Anyone should be proud of whatever race they are. You should see it, acknowledge that someone is different than you. But it's not a bad thing, but the world makes it out to be something. Racism is all over and you don't even know it. For me, going in a store and shopping and being looked at like I'm gonna steal something, that is being racist. It started when I was a child. People treated me differently because of the color of my skin. I wasn't allowed to have a part in a kid's musical theater because I didn't look like all the other kids. I was the only black girl in that entire group. So they basically told me, an 11-year-old girl, that I'm never gonna get a part because I don't look like every other kid there. But if you support Trump, you do not care about me or any other minority. He's not for the people. If you're the age of 18, you need to vote. You need to vote. November is coming and you need to vote. I think the most important thing right now is for us to continue what's going on. I don't think we should have all these protests and sign all these petitions and doing all the hard work we're doing right now and just let it fade away in like a week or two until we have to do the same thing over again in a month because another innocent black person was murdered for doing nothing, for just living their life. We need to continue this energy we have so there's actual change. So black people have a chance at just living life, you know? Because being black, you're born into a world with fear installed in you. It's just simple things we can't even do without just like, oh yeah, let me reach for my license and registration. Let me do that. No, it's like, shit, if I'm reaching for my license and registration, is this gonna be the thing that kills me? Is going on a walk in a park gonna be the thing that kills me? Is walking home gonna be the thing that kills me? Is going to school gonna be the thing that kills me? Is sitting in my own house gonna be the thing that kills me? I mean, that's the thing that black people have to go through every single day. You know, every single day. I just want us to have the same chance of freedom, like actual freedom, you know? We've already fought for so much. We fought for so much. We have gone through it. We have gone through it. We've fought for all of the rights we have right now, and we still have to fight. We still have to fight for the simplest things, for the simplest things. So all I'm asking is for everyone to keep this going. Keep the protests going. They're peaceful until cops want to be pigs and make them violent. To keep signing petitions. To keep having conversations. You know, those uncomfortable conversations really can make someone view something that they didn't understand a completely different way. You know, I've had those awkward conversations with family members and I'm in a group chat with them and they're all talking about what's going on in this world and they're just so caught up in their ways because obviously I have a white family. I don't know, like my mom's white, but my dad, obviously he was black and he was dark skinned. So she was with him when he would get pulled over and they made him step out of the car and handcuff him and do all this thing because they thought that he was a criminal. And she sees what I go through. I mean, she understands it, you know, and all she wants is, you know, equality for all of us. And so my mom really understands it, but like a lot of my family, they really just didn't get it, you know? And so I saw the group chat and I had to educate them because they don't know what it's like being black. They don't know exactly how it feels, but they can't try to understand what we're fighting for right now. I encourage you, have those awkward conversations with a family member, a friend, anyone. Just try to educate them on what this fight is for. We need to keep on going and we can do it. I really believe that if we stick together and we keep on fighting for what's right, we can do it. We are so powerful. We are so powerful. It's gonna be so hard for people not to listen to us. We just need to continue to use our voices because if you are silent, you are part of the problem. Police brutality is just, I mean, I hope that people who are in power will think twice before they continue to beat a man to death, murdering for no reason. I am praying for for George Floyd and his family and every other victim of all these hateful crimes, because that is not a way to leave this world. You should not be leaving this world at the hands of people who are supposed to protect you. I've personally lost a family member to police brutality. My uncle, he had the mind of a 12-year-old, 13-year-old, and he was dragged out of his apartment and beaten to death. Beaten to death. Because he was scared. That being said, guys, we're in this together. You know, we're fighting for what's right. We have a chance for equality, real equality. Black lives need to matter. But sometimes I feel scared to even speak out on certain situations because some people view me as not black enough. But when you look at me, you're gonna see a black girl. You're gonna see the color of my skin, and you're gonna categorize me as being a black girl. I've been called black bitch by multiple people multiple times and for the stupidest things. Because a boy liked me and not her, she wanted to call me a black bitch. Is a black bitch coming? I don't wanna hang out if the black bitch is there. Why do you like the black bitch? Why do you need it? Like, what? So yeah, I am a black woman and I'm proud, and you can't take away my experiences. I'm not gonna sit here and act like being a light skin isn't a privilege, because it is. If you have darker skin than me, people are gonna look at you differently. The world doesn't make sense. Sometimes people like to say that my life is easier, and I'm not trying to take away anyone's experiences, but don't try to take away my experiences. So that's the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna link down below articles to read just to really understand and educate yourself. Some places to donate. If you can't donate, literally don't worry about it. Anything counts. Signing a petition counts. If you go to a protest, it counts. Your voice is getting heard. No matter what you do, just do something. I love all of you guys so much. Yeah, okay. I'll see you next time. Bye.